Hello, this is Tim, and I'm here to tell you about BPOS Point of Sale for Hospitals. If you have one location or many locations, BPOS can help you centrally manage your operations for cafeterias and gift shops. There's many other things that BPOS adds to this. BPOS can help you manage payroll deductions, interdepartmental billing, meal plans for physicians or executives, vouchers and discounts for volunteers, and inventory for gift shops and cafeteria. So let's take a look at BPOS. So this is a login screen for BPOS. You can log into BPOS using a number, an employee card, or a fingerprint. So I'm gonna use a card today for our login. So I logged in, and that decides my permissions in the software once I get there. So now let's ring in a transaction. This transaction will be a cash transaction. So we'll just ring a few items, and this is cafeteria style, so I have no modifiers. Now BPOS does have the capability of managing modifiers and sending them to a kitchen, but in traditional hospital cafeteria, we wouldn't have those. Now in this case, I also have options for being able to do categories or products. In this case, I have a category, which was burgers, and it lists all of the burgers. So to do that again, I pick burger, and then I pick a burger off the list. But I also could have had all the burgers hard-coded, like I have cheeseburger right here. So I have a total here of $36, and I have fast tender keys down here. Now I can press cash and type in an amount, or I could have fast tender keys. I could press two $20 bills. Now my receipt printer prints and my cash drawer opens. You can teach a monkey to do that in 10 minutes. So let's do a transaction where we have an employee with a payroll deduction. Now in many hospitals, the employees have an employee badge, and that employee badge has a magnetic stripe, a barcode, or an RFID card in it. We can accept any one of those. And in this case, I'll do an RFID card for an employee card. So when the employee walks up, all they have to do is touch their card on the RFID reader. This brings up their account. And in this case, I have an account with a declining balance. Now it could have been a payroll deduction, a declining balance, it could have been a meal plan for a physician. Any one of these could have been accessed by the card. So I'll ring up some items for this person and we will charge them on account. Now, if they have a declining balance, that will automatically deduct from their declining balance as if that was a prepaid gift card. If they have a payroll deduction, that will automatically export on the payroll period to the payroll service for the payroll deduction. Now we could also do interdepartmental billing in a similar fashion. Now you could issue a number, and you probably already do have a number for interdepartmental billing charges, or I could look them up manually on a list. So I could type in the number that you need to look up, or I could look them up by pressing the finance department. So I pick it, I'm gonna charge to the finance department, and I ring up whatever it is that they're gonna get, and then I will pay on account. And then your accounting department will automatically get an exported report on a scheduled basis. Let's say it's the first of the month or every 2 weeks or as often as they'd like to get, with an Excel spreadsheet that shows up in their inbox or in some file location for them to import into their accounting package, or we could set it up that it automatically imports into the accounting package. So the next thing is we'll look at vouchers that you could issue to volunteers or other guests that you want to give a meal to. Now, in this case, I've printed off a paper voucher. Now, I could have issued it on a gift card for that person, but in this case, I did it on a paper voucher, and the voucher has a barcode that I could use to redeem by scanning the barcode at the register. Now, I could have done this by just typing in a number too. So I'll ring up an item that this person wants to get. They want to get a cheeseburger. Now, the rule on this is they get up to $6, and the cheeseburger that I've just rung is $7.25. So I'll scan the coupon, and it will automatically discount off $6. So I have $1.25, and that volunteer who gets a $6 credit in the cafeteria can now pay the balance difference with a $5 bill for their $1.25, and we completed the transaction. Now, can that be redeemed twice? If I ring up a burger again and then scan the voucher, it will tell me that this voucher has been fully redeemed. It cannot be redeemed twice. Now, this voucher also could have an expiration date. So if the volunteer came in, let's say 2 weeks later, and the voucher was issued with only being valid for 7 days, the voucher would also not work after that expiration date. So the next thing we can look at is a meal plan for a voucher or an executive. Now, your meal plan could be a certain number of free meals or discounted meals per day, week, or month, however you'd like to arrange that. So if this person were to come in and present their card, we could scan the card, which would bring up their account. I have this set up with the exact same promotion that we had for volunteers, which is they got a $6 discount. Now, there could be some other plan in what they get, but in this case, they get a sandwich. When I ring this up, it says, you have a valid voucher for this product. Do you wish to redeem this voucher now? And if I say redeem, so now I have $1.25, just like we had for the volunteer, and it's the same process. It's just that that voucher has been attached to the account for the executive or for the physician, whereas a volunteer, you would likely give that to in paper. So BPOS can also handle your inventory, not only for your cafeteria with recipe level breakdown of all of your items, but BPOS can also handle complex inventory needs that are required in a gift shop. So in this case, we've got the gift shop set up. I've got barcodes, and of course we're scanning barcodes all day long, so I ring up the bottle of water. We could access items on the touchscreen and do them by the touchscreen too. So I could ring up those items. And again, this process is just the same as the cafeteria, only I'm now selling retail items instead of cafeteria items, but I'm doing them by barcode. But in the background, we're doing all the inventory deductions and tracking how many you have on hand and doing purchases from outside vendors. So that concludes our presentation of BPOS point of sale for hospitals. Of course, there's way more features than we could possibly talk about in this short presentation. If you have more questions, please call us and we'll be happy to talk to you about your needs.